Yesterday we were discussing abortion, and I was just wondering, like, it says in the book, as soon as conception is like happens, life starts. So as soon as like the sperm meets the egg, but as soon as that happens, it's only just a pack of cells for that moment. When does like the soul actually come into it?
You see, the Hindu religion is always open to interpretation and open to challenges of rationality and common sense. It never says, oh, you know, it's written in book, it's written, this is it. So the question is very interesting. In fact, before I present Hinduism, I think about all these things for myself. And unless they satisfy me, I don't agree. I won't even teach. I'm very severe. Unless they make sense to me personally, I will not even bother to teach it. So this issue of when does the soul enter the body? The book says at the time of conception. How did we come across that idea? In some Hindu scripture, they say it happens after 7 months when the baby starts kicking. You know, they will say, in some books they will say that's when the soul enters. I would not agree. Let me tell you why I think like that. You see, what happens is this. At the time of conception, when the two cells meet, there is immediately gastrulation is the word, the biological term. Gastrulation takes place. It means the cells begin to divide and subdivide and start to become character, you know, different characteristics begin to develop. Still a mass of cells. You say, where is the soul? The soul is making its appearance known in the way the gastrulation is taking place, the way these cells are subdividing. It is already, if you like, in charge of the way the division is taking place. How do I know? There's a lot of research done by Professor Stevenson on reincarnation, and he came up with one idea which immediately touched me. He said, if somebody has been violently killed, say with a bullet or with a sword, then when that person, because he's done case studies, they get autopsy reports, when that person is reborn, that person has got a birthmark in the place where he was shot or hit. A birthmark appears. So now the birthmark doesn't appear after 7 months. When the gastrulation process is beginning, it's already going to show that kind of flow in the physical body. So I'm saying right from the time of gastrulation, when those cells are dividing and subdividing, the new soul is already in charge and dictating the way it's subdividing. Because it's going to, in a way, dictate the physical characteristic of that individual. It's already in charge. You say, where is it in charge? You see, this is a very interesting question, because where does the soul reside? Does it reside in the womb? It's sitting there, I'm here. Not like that. It's a metaphysical thing, not a physical thing, that is in a way trying to harness the physical. So it's trying to influence the physical, but it's essentially metaphysical. But it's beginning to now, in a way, already direct the way the body is being formed to suit its character. It already has got a character. This character wants to become visible, manifested, so it starts to, in a way, show its colors right from the time of conception, because that's the process of gastrulation. And the individual is born. As soon as the two cells meet, the individual is automatically, immediately linked. Otherwise, who is dictating it? Where does the birthmark come from, for example? So I'm saying from the time of gastrulation, from the time of conception, the soul doesn't have a size. It doesn't matter if there are four cells or two cells. The soul doesn't have any size. It is beyond size, beyond idea of size. It's already influencing the way this body, these cells are dividing and subdividing and rearranging themselves to produce a body. And the reason is Professor Stevenson's research that makes me sure it must happen at time of gastrulation, not after 7 months, because already the birthmark should be there, start becoming visible, not after 7 months. So this is the reason why I think about this thing for myself. And unless they satisfy my own common sense, I will not present it as Hinduism. And I'll say, I don't know. I'll be very honest, but this is the answer. It's a very, very, very good question.